Hi there, Bruno here. Today, I'll try to explain the different ways you can connect Lambot with other tools using native integrations, webhooks, or connectors. So, integrations are a great way to keep all your data synced all across your stack, enhancing your productivity. But at the beginning, it can be a bit overwhelming. So at Lambot, we like to arrange them in three types, which are native, connectors, and custom. So, native integrations. They are the most straightforward kind. They are ready to use and you don't need a single line of code to make them work. Just connect your MailChimp, Slack, or Google Sheets account. Select the data you want to send and where to send it. Then, Lambot will do the rest for you. The next type is connectors, with Zapier being the industry leader. It allows Lambot to be set up as a trigger and use any third-party software as the action app. The trigger is a Zapier block within your Lambot flow. It contains all the data the bot was able to capture until it's reached. Within your Zapier account, you can select that trigger and set action by creating a Zap. Update a deal in Pipedrive, send an SMS through Twilio, or even create a Spotify playlist. There are thousands of apps available. Finally, for code lovers, we created the webhooks. These are HTTPS requests you can make to any given endpoint. You'll be able to customize the method, body, and header to have Lambot do exactly what you want to do with your data, back and forth. So that was it. I hope you're now ready to leverage Lambot integrations. I'm Bruno, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.